These are the 5 basic tips you need to know if you're new to WAN 2.2 Animate. If you've already set up the workflow but still have no clue how to actually use it, this video's for you. Hey everyone, I've been getting a ton of questions about WAN 2.2 Animate lately, especially after my setup tutorial. So in this video, I'll go through the most common questions from the comments and break them down as simply as possible. Let's jump right in. Number 1, resolution tips. For your information, many of you are generating videos at 488/832, which is basically 480p. That's totally fine if you're using a low VRAM GPU, but if you want to increase the resolution, you can go up to 720x1280 for 720p quality. Just keep in mind, higher resolution means heavier GPU workload, and low VRAM cards might not handle it well or could even crash. Another option is to upscale your video later. Artificial Lab has shown this method in his video. It basically uses the Ultimate SD upscale node, and it works really well. So if you want higher quality without stressing your GPU, that's worth checking out. Number 2, output without reference image. Some people asked how to output video only, since the original workflow from KJ doesn't do that by default. Here's the fix. If you want to export your final video without the reference image showing on the left, just connect the Get Image Size and Count node directly to the Video Combine node. That's it. You'll get a clean video output. Number 3, pose transfer. Reverse the process. By default, this workflow replaces the character in your video with your reference image. But what if you want to do the opposite? Transfer the video's movement and audio onto your reference image. Yes, you can. It's actually simple. Just remove the Get Mask node and the Get Background Image node, and it will work. However, for more stable results, make sure your aspect ratio matches the video and try to control distortion before you run the workflow. To match the aspect ratio, you can put in extra effort by using Flux Context, Quen Image Edit, or even Nano Banana to match the first frame of the video input. With this extra step, your video output will be much more stable. I've also noticed that when replacing an anime character, the results are sometimes much worse compared to replacing a real human. Because of this, I now prefer using pose transfer whenever I work with anime characters. Number 4, understanding frame count. For more advanced users, it's important to understand how frame count works. The Set Frame Count node calculates the total number of frames in your video and sends it to the WAN Video Animate Embeds node. By default, each run generates 81 frames. The frame window size must always follow the formula 4n plus 1. For example, 77 and 81 both fit this formula. Here's the quick math. If you're using 16 FPS, then 81 frames by 16 equals about 5 seconds of video per run. If your video is shorter than 5 seconds, no problem. But if it's longer, things can get unstable when you try to generate more than 81 frames in one go. That's where the concept of windows comes in. Let's say you have 162 frames. The first 81 frames run in window 1, your first 5 seconds, and the next 81 frames run in window 2. Finally, both clips are combined into a single 10-second video. But if your video has 150 frames, the first window generates 81 frames, leaving 69 frames. The system will still run another full batch of 81 frames for the second window, which means it'll auto-generate 12 extra frames to fill the gap. That's why you sometimes see unwanted or off-sync frames at the end. So always calculate your total frames before generating. Number 5, swap multiple character. Some of you asked if it's possible to swap more than one character in the same video. Yes, it is, but you'll need to run the process multiple times. Mask the first character and generate, then mask the second character and run it again. Most demos only show one character because multi-character animation is unstable and requires extra effort to get good results. Speaking of stability, I've noticed that while GJOF and FP8 models produce similar quality, FP8 is actually more stable for longer videos. One viewer mentioned they could run the Q4K model with just 6 GB of VRAM, and I've personally tested BF16 with 34.5 gigabytes on a 5090, and it runs fine too. So those results check out. And here's a small update. Kijai has just released the new FP8 V2 model, which offers even better quality and stability than the previous version. If your GPU supports it, definitely give it a try. Last but not least, I feel guilty when I can't solve some of your problems in the comment section. If anyone has a better idea to fix this issue, please let me know in the comments. The problem is this. If you encounter a CUDA out of memory error, based on my personal experience, there are three things you can adjust. First, try switching to a smaller GGF model. Next, try increasing the block swap to 40. Lastly, lower the frame window batch size using the 4n plus 1 formula. You can also reduce the video length. For example, if you're using an 8GB VRAM GPU, avoid putting videos longer than 3 to 5 seconds. If it still can't be solved, please forgive me. I'm out of ideas. These tips are very important, and I hope you fully understand them, because in the next video, the workflow might not be low VRAM friendly. However, you can still make it work by manually adjusting the inputs as mentioned in this video. That's it for today's quick breakdown of WAN 2.2 Animate. I hope this clears up most of your questions. If you found this helpful, don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment below what workflow or topic you'd like me to cover next. Once again, thanks for 700 subscribers. I really appreciate it, and I'll see you in the next video.